Hi guys, Jill here with a video related to the Coco Daisy, the current Coco Daisy Facebook fans scrapathon, whatever we're calling it. And I am working with you guys on Sunday, and we will be talking about using the Up and Away kit and maybe some other kit items in 12 by 12 scrapbooking. And I wanted to do just one quick video. It'll be a kind of a partial process video because I have a feeling I'll be doing some other things with this page as I go along and before I post it on the Facebook page. And I just want to encourage you to try, if you haven't already, moving these supplies into the 12 by 12 format, or you know, any other format that's a little different than what you're used to, because it's kind of fun to shake things up that way. This is a very cheery spring kit, so I am using a photo here of crocuses. Now, I'll admit this is from last year because I haven't seen any crocuses yet this year, but I did see my first robin today, and today is pretty much the first day of spring, so that was exciting. So I'm just titling this First Robin, First Flower, using the stickers from the kit and these puffy stickers as well. Also, I think these are from the sticker kit. And one thing, I wanted to just explain a couple things in what I've got planned here. It's kind of a little bit like a loose grid or like a partial grid with a line moving through it for the design. And I had this idea of taking these cute papers, the watercolor papers with flowers and leaves are just so so cool, and just hand cutting them, kind of like adding to the charm, and that's so simple to do. So if you you can use punches too if you want to create this effect that's with a little more regularity. But I did kind of the opposite. I like deliberately cut them unevenly and just wanted to get some energy and personality onto the page through hand cutting. So, you know, as you know, you just use the scissors, keep the scissors still, and then move your paper through. And these are kind of Katie Light inspired. I took a class with her a few years ago, and she uses a lot of this shape in her art journaling. But if you cut a circle, then just cut notches in it all the way around, and that gives you a little bit of a flower-like shape, very loose. When you arrange these, you're probably, I'm like just starting to do that, you're probably going to want to just play with them, see what looks right to you. I put a few squares in there as well. The other thing I want to mention is I'm going to use stickers, but I hand cut them. I took the round stickers from the kits, and just so that they work well and will integrate with the hand cut paper, and used some with flowers and some with sayings like spring vibes, so forth. I typed my journaling on some of the pattern paper. And I'm gonna kind of, as I said, have that below the photo and below the strip of hand-cut embellishments. We got this wonderful baker's twine and a rainbow of colors this month. So I thought I would take a couple of the colors. I'm kind of working with the purple, I'm kind of working with the yellow for complementary, and some orange. And then of course green to celebrate spring. So hopefully like all those colors will be pulled together eventually with this. I also intend to do a little bit of stitching here. And also, we got these rainbow enamel dots, not rainbow, but raindrop enamel dots. And so, yes, of course, rain is a huge part of spring. So I'll probably like integrate some of these, have them cascade down. So stay tuned to see the picture when I'm all done with this. But I wanted to take you a little bit into the process in case you want to interpret this in your own way, use these supplies, but use some of the same ideas or techniques. Anyway, thanks for joining me for this quick video. Catch up with you guys later.